Hey guys, what's up? This is Mike from McProgramming.org. I have been getting a lot of questions as far as how to compile programs on the command line and pass in arguments because all my videos are Eclipse based, so people don't understand how to do it on the command line, and that's a very tough thing to do if you've never programmed before because it's quite overwhelming, and I know your professors and teachers out there want you to do that for your lab work and stuff. So I'm going to show you how to do that real quick. I'm in Notepad++ and I'll just type up a really quick program. I will compile it and run it on the command line, and then I'll also write a very short program and I'll pass in an argument and show you how to run that on the command line. So what we need to do now is we need to create a class, public class, and I called it command line args. Right, open it up with some curly brackets, and then we have public static void main. And inside of main, you may have realized that it's always written as string square brackets args. And the square brackets, as you know, is a array, so it takes in a string array of arguments, and args is just kind of the generic word for it. You can kind of name it whatever you want, but string and these square brackets have to be there. But if you notice, you don't always have to pass in a string of args, but you can, and I'm going to show you how. Well, in the second compiling of this. So let's just print some out. System.out.println. I'll just say McProgramming. McProgramming. Sure, everything looks good. All right, so now what I need to do, I want to make sure it's saved, and I have this on my desktop. So I'm gonna go to my command prompt, and make sure you go to your desktop or wherever you saved it at least. And to change directories, you go cd, and well, let me show you how to see what's in the directory first. So I'm in the mic directory. You want to say dir, hit enter, and you see all the things I have. Well, I want to go to desktop. So what you do is you say cd for change directory, and I'm in Windows. So in Windows, you can say de. You can put in one letter if you want. Just hit tab, and it'll auto-complete it. If you have a couple things that start with that letter, it may not be the first thing that comes up. Just hit it a few times until you see it, then hit enter. And now we're in the desktop, and you could do the directory again to just make sure it's in there, but I know it is. So the way we compile a file is we say Java C for Java compiler, and then we want to say command, and there we go. If you hit the tab, it auto completes it for you. Make sure you have the .java on there and it's the correct file. Hit enter, and if this comes back up like this, it means you're good to go. If you got a bunch of errors spit out at you got to go fix the problem and try it again. So now what we can do is we can just say Java, and then we say command, spell a couple letters, hit tab, and notice that dot class comes back. And if I hit tab again, it'll say dot Java, so you can switch between them, but the dot class is the one we want to run, but we don't want to have dot class on there, so just get rid of that to where it says command line args, but make sure it's that dot class file. Hit enter, and then it printed out right here, McProgramming. All right, so now if we want to pass in something into this right here, this is what we do. Let's say hello, we'll concatenate that with args 0. And what that means is, since we're passing in an array of strings, that first index of the array, I'm just going to pass in one argument, which is going to be a name. And it's going to say hello, and it's going to grab that first argument, which would be index 0. If you haven't gotten to arrays yet, this is the array syntax, and 0 is where the first element is. So you're always a number behind. That's just the computer way of doing it. So let's run that now. Let's go back to our command. Save this. Let's go back to our command prompt. And what we do now, we need to compile it again because we changed the code. So Java C command dot Java. All right, hit it. We're good to go. Now Java command, get rid of the dot class, and then add a space, and then you can put in your argument. You don't need to worry about putting quotation marks or anything around it. All you have to do is pass in whatever it is, because it will be, even if I pass in a number, it would still be considered a string. So you'd have to change that later in your program. If you're passing in like an integer, you'd have to change that string to an int. Well, now let me just pass in my name. I'll say Mike. And when I hit enter, this is getting passed in right here into this argument right here. And then it's, since it's the only thing that's in there, it is the first element, which is arg0. And it should concatenate what I passed in with hello. So here we go. Hello, Mike. And I'm going to show you that I'm going to add the index 2 into the arguments. I'll pass in 3 arguments. And notice that the third one is the one that gets executed. So let's run that again. All right. So Java, C, command line args.java. Compile, that works. Java, CO, here we go. All right, so I'm gonna say Mike, John, Jeff. And it says, hello, Jeff. So that's how you can pass in a array of strings, and that is what this means. This may have looked crazy before, and you never knew why it was like that, but that's why, so we can pass in these type of values. So thank you all for watching, and I hope this made a little bit of sense. And please subscribe below if you haven't. Thank you, guys.